Hi, I'm Analytical, your friendly neighborhood drag queen and a top-tier tech educator. Welcome to today's tutorial. What are we going to build today? I've been seeing all over Instagram those right above your head. Who are you? What are you? Which one are you? Which thingy are you? You know, you get a little bit of the face blur, you get a little brrr up top, and then bam, you're Carrie Bradshaw, you're Trixie Mattel, you're Velma. Ooh, jinkies. I definitely can't see without my glasses. So we're gonna build one of these today. And I was thinking, what better internet icon of the moment than Claire Saffitz from the Bon Appetit Test Kitchen? I would die for Claire from the Bon Appetit Test Kitchen. I figure we should make an Instagram filter that determines which Claire Gourmet Makes recipe are you. If you're following along at home, I'll provide you all the images I'm using, but feel free to use any images you want, create any kind of generator that you want to make. Come on over, let's get started. And it's actually going to involve not too much code. So we're going to search Spark AR Studio and go to this link. It's by Facebook, obviously, because it's Instagram by Facebook now. And you're just going to want to scroll around, you know, view all the page, and then you'll find the download link. You can open Spotlight and just search for Spark AR Studio. Once you've gone through the standard installation process, just open it like a regular application. When it loads, you're probably going to be given a little bit of a tutorial, which you could follow. You know, why not? It's pretty helpful. And then there are a few templates which you can use. And I think I might... Why don't I open one of the templates so I can show you kind of what the idea of what this application does. You're given this kind of 3D workspace area, which you can kind of zoom around in, rotate. And you can see the screen, the live demo. And then here in this corner, you get kind of like a visualization of what it's going to look like on your phone. And they've got a few different people you could try it out on. There's this person, this person, this person, these people, lots of different people. A very nice, diverse set of people. Good on you, Facebook. And you can always use yourself using clicking FaceTime HD camera. Oh! So we'll use this guy. And basically you can see, here's the workspace. There's like a light they put in. There's this face tracker, which will follow the face. They've used some augmented reality, some machine learning, lots of cool things to generate all this. And there's a face mesh. And that's like inside of this face tracker. So it looks like it's gonna follow it around. Looks like there are a few of these. Down here are the different assets. So we can see this is where the mask is. So you could right click and do replace and replace it with your own image to do your own kind of face mask. If you really want to just do like an easy one. If you're a Photoshop wizard, you can go in, make your own mask, do it up that way, do your own little drag. You know, do your drag. Augmented reality, Instagram filter. And then down here is kind of where they have the code. And if you watched any of my videos before, we've done some drag and drop coding with Scratch. We also do some JavaScript coding. And this is actually a great way to dive into a little bit of coding. You can do it all with drag and drop, but you can also add your own scripts, which and you'd code that in JavaScript. But we'll probably just do the drag and drop for now. So you can get a very basic idea of cool things you can do with just drag and drop coding. Let's just start with a blank project. You're going to want to open the patch editor so you can have where you'll put all those drag and drop coding blocks. And the first thing we're going to need to do is blur out those lines, baby. It's not an Instagram filter if you're going to have the slightest wrinkle, because in 2020, we love to make ourselves feel better about the way we look in photos, even though we all look really beautiful without lots of filters. But we want this to be a successful filter, so we're going to cater to the mainstream media. So we're going to right click it here and add a new face mesh. And now you get this kind of cool face filter. Honestly, like this would be, I'd like end it here. I'm like, okay, cool. Amazing filter. This would be seen as like witchcraft if you went back like 30 years. So we've got this face mesh and we're going to need a material for it. So we just click plus there and it gives us a material. Okay. let's name this smooth face, just so we know we want to keep track of it. When you're coding, or when you're using an IDE, this is like an integrated development environment, it's a very powerful tool for you to keep track of everything, but you need to work with it. It gives you a setup to do that. So it already organizes it into materials, but if we have 20 materials, we're going to want to know what each one of those is. And like with coding, you're going to have a bunch of files. You want to have clear file names. You want to have clear variable names. The smooth phase. And now there are a bunch of different types for shaders. We want the retouching one. And here there's an option to smooth to various levels. So we can go to 0 all the way to 100. 100 is a little much. I'm going to pause this just so we can see it really clearly. That's 0. That's 100. That's like season 1 Drag Race filter. I feel like, you know, like 30 might be good. First order of business is taken care of. So then the next thing we're going to want to do is we've got this face tracker. So we're going to want to add a plane. I'm just going to add a plane actually outside of there. So you see when he moves, it doesn't get tracked with it. But when we put it inside of this face tracker, then it'll follow along. I'm going to pause this just so we can position it correctly. In this kind of 3D space, if you hold command, you can rotate around, you can zoom in with scroll wheel, and you can kind of position it where you want it. A lot of them go at like right above the head. So we can go there, we can make it a little bigger. As we saw with our face mesh, when we have these checkerboard grids, we need to add our own material for that. So we'll click on plane over here, add a material. And now here's where we're going to want to add the choices. We're going to add the different, what are these? Different clairs. So that's our material for this. I think we can have it be flat or standard. And I'm not an expert in this, but one thing I did when you're learning new code or learning a new tool is watch a few tutorials on it like this. Play around with it, go through the help that they provide, and also change all the values and see what happens, because literally nothing bad is going to happen. If you, you accidentally delete everything and it's all broken, or you change this value to 33 and you're like, oh no, I didn't know what opacity was. Okay, great. You just learned. Look, now the thing is not as, it's more clear, there's more transparency. Or what's this tile thing? I don't know. Does it do anything? Nope, doesn't do anything. So you just leave it alone and you are all good. So now that we've got this material, we're going to want to add an animation sequence. What is it? Animation sequence. And this is where we're going to store all the images and we can like loop through them. So what are we going to call this? We'll call this also clairs. I know they're called the same, but you can kind of see here there's like this is the material because it has a little sphere, and this is the animation sequence because it has the play and the slider. And for our texture, we're going to choose a file. We're going to choose multiple files. We'll get all the ones that are in Claire. We can just hold shift to select them and click open. And nothing happened. But again, with programming, you're always learning, okay, I set something up. Why didn't anything happen? With programming, you always have to tell what you want to happen. So we know we have our material Claire, which is on this plane. And we didn't know that. We clicked the plane. We could see, okay, here's this material. So we can go in here and actually select the material right here. And now we need to choose our texture. And if you'll look right here, a texture is created for us from this animation sequence. So we'll click this little drop down and select Claire's. All right, bam, we've got our Claire's. Oh, and now they are animating through. We can click loop to guess to stop them. Randomize. We're actually not going to need to touch any of this right now, or touch any of this for our project. Basically, there are multiple frames in this animation sequence. So each frame is a new image of Claire. And this is kind of like sprite animation that we looked at in Beyond Binary episode 1 in Scratch. So if you haven't seen that, go check it out. I'll put a link in the bio. So here we can see there's a current frame. There's just as current fra, you know, not the best software design, is, you know, this. A lot of room there, but current frame. And this little arrow means that we can interact with it. So I'm going to click it. And now here in our patch editor, we've got this current frame setup. So I'm just going to put the arrow key so we can see this is frame 0. This is frame 1, frame 2, frame 3, frame 4, etc. And again, we are programmers, so we start counting at 0 because of the binary. And you can learn all about that in Beyond Binary, because again, cross-promotion. So in here, you can see there's a little arrow, and this is an input for a number. So we can right-click and see there are a ton of different options here. And it's a little overwhelming. There's stuff for animation, there's stuff to play some audio, there's stuff about your device, face landmarks. And I encourage you all to go play around with all this because there's a ton of cool stuff. But we just want to grab... Do we want to grab? Let's search for random. All right. That worked. So now there's some stuff that takes in the randomize and will output it into this Claire value. It looks like here, I'm gonna see, what do we need for random? So here it gives us a little bit of documentation, which is helpful. And it says we need something that's gonna give us like a pulse. So like we could do a finger tap to get this started. So I'll do that. So tap, screen tap. And when you tap, so you click on this arrow and drag it into randomize, that hopefully gives us a new option. And if you look, it is changing these values, but they're not really helpful values for us. It's like this value is like 8,665, but we know we only have 8 images. So we want this start value to be 0, and we want it to go all the way up to 8. And we're also going to need to round this number. We're going to need to round this number because it's giving us any number between 0 and 8, but we want only the numbers 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or up to 7. We don't have any decimal frames in here. So instead of dragging it to Claire's, we can drag that to round, and then we drag round into Claire's. And let's try this again. All right. So every time we click, we get a new image. Once we tap the screen, we will set a timer for maybe 5 seconds. It'll roll through all the clips and then stop on whichever frame it's on. So to do that, we're going to want to get a timer. So to do that, we can go and grab runtime, which has our timer. And here the output will be the time. And let's see if we can just drag it into randomize. So we can't drag it into randomize. We actually need a few of these puzzle pieces in between here. So I'm going to drag them over just so we have a little bit more room. I should even drag this up. Can I do that? You do not want to give us a lot of room for editing in this. Oh, I got it. All right, we're going to work with the screen space that we have. So randomize, this takes in some kind of pulse object. So we know that's kind of where we want our output to be, and our input is just the time. So one thing we can do with a pulse object is go into this loop animation. Every time a loop starts, it will keep sending pulses. So we're gonna drag the looped queue, not the progress, we're gonna drag looped into randomize. So now every second, it's gonna keep updating those images. So we're getting closer. Maybe we wanna do it every 0.25 seconds. Because you kind of want it to be like, ugh, what's gonna happen? Drama, you know? Da da da. And now we need something that's gonna enable this or disable this. So when we stop it, that's where it's gonna land. And we want to do this based on the runtime. So let's get the value. So we just need to do a little value in here so we can print it out. And if this value is less than, I don't know, maybe let's say 5 seconds, then we'll keep updating it. But when it's more than that, then we're going to stop. And that's the image you've gotten selected. So we want to go into logic here and do while it is less than 5. We drag it in here to enable it. Oh, click restart. Duh. And now you can see the value is increasing all the way up. And then once we get to 5, it stopped. There is so many different variations you can do on this. We could have all of this start only once it's tapped. You could do once you like nod your shoulders, you could start it. You could have a question that comes up before saying, which Claire are you going to be? And have that be part of this. So really, this is just a way for you to get started to see, oh, what kind of cool things can I build as an Instagram filter? And this is enough to get you started. So I'm going to save this as which Claire. And now that that's saved, you can upload this. It's going to check that all of our files meet these requirements. And it's going to see if we can publish this new effect. So, okay, upload. And we'll open this publishing tool. We'll select Instagram. We can select the effect name, which player from the Bon Appetit Test Kitchen are you? We could add some kind of effect. Let's see if I can add a little. I'll just add one of these images. And then we've read the legal agreements. And then we'd upload and continue. Uploading. Oh, so I guess you can all preview this before it's published. So that'd be kind of cool. And then you can just go through all these reviews and you can submit all this to review it, see if you like it. And then you submit it for a review for them and they'll accept it to the App Store. I'm going to clean this up a little bit more, you know, add a little preview screen, maybe add some particle effects. I wonder if we can even add some of those now. Particle system. That's kind of nice if you hook it up to the face tracker. You can do all sorts of things. You could have, what kind of, again, you can add a material to these particles. You could add the little clears to the particles. Oh my God. There's so many things you can play with this. And it's so nice that the technology is like really in your hands and you could do kind of whatever you want with this. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. Let me know if you want me to play more with Spark AR, make some more Instagram filters. Leave a comment below if there's an Instagram filter you might want me to make, or if you make any, post the link below. I'd love to share it out and get all of those filters on my face. I think it's so great Facebook's made this really great way that anyone can build their own kind of filters and represent them in Instagram in a way they want to be represented, or even make a game with a fun filter that expresses all the things they love. And you don't have to learn a ton of tech to it, but when you're doing it, you learn about some Boolean operations, less than, greater than. You can use random numbers and rounding. And if you're learning to code for the first time, all these concepts actually come up all the time when you're writing an application, but they're so much more boring when they're taught in computer science class, when your professor says, I'd like you to write a function that rounds a number. I'd like you to write a multiplication and rounding function. Thank you. That's not going to be any fun for you to learn. So I want you to go around and play with this. Play with all these different ways you can interact. You can do eyebrows lowered, eyebrows raised, head nod, head rotation, head shake. And you can do a little bit of math in here and make the particles go in a beautiful formation using some math. Apply some of that math that you know. All right, that's all for this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, leave a like, comment, subscribe, ring the bell. You know the dealio. Very important, links to all my Instagram filters that I build are going to be in the description below. So go give me a follow on Instagram and you can apply this Claire one and maybe I'll make a cursed Drag Race images one. Maybe I'll make a Drag Race winner. Maybe I'll make just like a gay one because we're taking technology into our hands now. I failed the junk pop. All right, goodbye.